Well, despite the pandemic, Gamudanland has done very well, thanks to my colleagues and friends in Gamudanland. For the year itself, we chalk up about 2.2 billion of worth of sales. And the last quarter itself, which is post the MCO, we actually achieved 1 billion sales in one quarter, which is very good, And this is possible because they have responded to the pandemic differently. Few things that have happened along the way. One is that they have done a lot of online deals, which was take off 2 weeks into the MCO, which helped the projects a lot. Secondly, the e-commerce. Yeah, the e-commerce itself allowed them to do a lot more deals, engagement with the customers, and especially bookings and sales and payment, you know. And last but not least, they also roll out the Gamudanland Experiential Gallery, Virtual Gallery, in July, which helped the customers to navigate and look at our products that we have virtually, 3D virtual walkthrough that allowed them to see the product even though there's a movement control. I think the more important part is the safety. We all know that the pandemic itself forced everyone to follow the SOP, social distancing, you know, testing and tracing. So for Gamuda, that safety level has even gone up. We even have our PCR lab, yeah, that help all the people in the group, including Gamudanland. And that itself is most important to make people feel safe, even to work and for customer to come into our project. Yeah. Secondly, it's about adoption of technologies. Yeah. Just now, I mentioned about those e-commerce, online deals, and Gamudanland virtual experiential gallery. These are the things that we have adopted to deal with the pandemic. And most importantly is making sure that our product is relevant to a new norm, yeah, a post-pandemic product. Projects like Gamuda Gardens, they have rolled out Ilaria, which is designed based on requirement of more open space, better aerations, work from home areas, you know. So we see that products even have adapted to the new norm. Yeah. So I see that that those are the key things that help us to deal with the pandemic. For 2021, I'm quite positive about it. A lot of things that my colleagues and friends are already doing. What they have done today to launch Ilaria in Gamuda Gardens, and also things like in Gamudanland 25/7 projects, the launching of the mall in December 2020, and newer products, post-pandemic products that we roll out in Gamuda Cove. So we are seeing that besides the good sales of the existing launches, new launches that befits the post-pandemic new norm will even be more attractive. And this will be a good time for them to even buy. Good deals are abound. So I see that they will pick up more. For overseas projects like Vietnam, has always been good and is the fastest growing economy in Southeast Asia. And I see that the sales is good for the last 2 years, contributing 2/3 of our result. And I see that they'll continue to contribute positively or substantially to Gamudanland result. We have basically seen vaccine likely to be rolled out. So Singapore will be the likely economy that will pick up very fast. Yeah, the property market there will be good. So our project, Ola Residence, will continue to be a sought after project. So all in all, we're looking at about 3.5 billion sales for financial 2021, which is 50% higher than in financial year 2020. So I see very positive. My colleagues and friends in Gamuda Land, they are high-spirited. They have seen what they have done post-pandemic. Even during lockdown, roll out of the digital initiatives, good sales in last quarter of financial 2020, and picking up of sales in financial year 2021. I do see that they have very strong belief. So what I can only say to them is that continue to believe in it, and for those who are still have a little bit of doubt, adapt quickly and be resourceful. Don't worry, we are always there to support them. To my friends and colleagues in Gamuda Land, stay safe, believe in yourself, and move forward knowing that we are always behind you.